वेलकम माय डियर स्टूडेंट इन दिस न्यू टॉपिक ऑफ द मेमोरी यूनिट. नाउ द वेरी जैसे कि हमने लास्ट वीडियो तक मेमोरी के रिलेटेड सारी इंपॉर्टेंस चीजें देख ली थी. डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मेमोरी अवेलेबल एंड हाउ दे कैन वर्क, हाउ वी कैन फॉरगेट देम इन टर्म्स ऑफ द साइज, कॉस्ट एंड स्पीड ऑफ ऑपरेशन एंड ऑल दिस थिंग्स दैट वी कैन कवर इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो. Now in this video we have to cover the important topic related to the memory, that is memory hierarchy, and how that memory is to be flow from top to bottom or bottom to top in terms of the different parameters. So doing the memory hierarchy on the basis of different parameter, and again we can take parameter is like the size, and then it like as a speed, and then it as a cost. On the basis of speed, size and cost, we can arrange here the different memory parts and on the basis of these three different parameter. The first foremost, if we can go from top to bottom, in that case we can see here the first is the processor part. This block is given as the processor. It means the internal parts of the CPU. Why I can say here the internal part of the CPU. So we will talk with the internal part, because internal part of the CPU, it contain a processor. Or in terms of the processor, there are again two memory parts, two memory element are here. In that case, the first memory element is the register. Now as we already know, the register is nothing but by using the combination of different flip-flops, that is the 8-bit register, 16-bit register. So that in the processor there is one memory element that we can call it as a register. Then the next and very important thing is that primary cache is another memory part, another memory unit will be there, which is coming in the level of 1, that is L1. So primary cache is one other thing. Then if we can go away from the processor, we can see here the another thing is that is secondary cache, which will be in the part of the level 2, that is secondary cache. Then after the secondary cache, the next is the important term is that the main memory is again important 6, and then at last is the magnetic disk or the secondary memory. That secondary memory is the anything that magnetic disk, pen drive, floppy disk, anything that we have can connect externally, memory card also. These are the different memory hierarchy. Now here we can write given this memory hierarchy, that register, primary cache, secondary cache, main memory, magnetic disk, and secondary. So we can arrange it by different. Now if you can see this arrow, you will find that increasing in size. Here if it goes from the register to primary cache, to secondary cache, main memory and magnetic disk and secondary memory. So agar aap is hisab se aate ho, to yahan pe memory ki size din ba din badh rahi hai. Jaise register primary cache register se jata hai, secondary cache primary cache se jata hai, main memory ki secondary cache se phenk jata hai, aur magnetic disk aur secondary memory aap dekhenge to main memory se uski size jata hai. So ye ho gaya in terms of the increasing size. If you can discuss about the speed and cost, तो आपको ये ख्याल में आएगा कि मैग्नेटिक डिस्क की स्पीड सबसे कम है, उसके बाद मेन मेमोरी की स्पीड उससे थोड़ी ज़्यादा, सेकेंडरी कैश की स्पीड उससे थोड़ी ज़्यादा, प्राइमरी कैश की स्पीड उससे थोड़ी ज़्यादा, और रजिस्टर की स्पीड सबसे ज़्यादा. तो हियर स्पीड इज इंक्रीज इन बॉटम टू टॉप. एंड इफ यू कैन डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉस्ट पर बीट, तो कॉस्ट पर बीट पे भी आपकी सेकेंडरी मेमोरी में कॉस्ट कम आएंगे, मेन मेमोरी में उससे ज़्यादा, सेकेंडरी कैसे में उससे थोड़ी ज़्यादा, प्राइमरी कैसे में उससे ज़्यादा, और रजिस्टर में सबसे ज़्यादा. इसका मतलब क्या है कि कॉस्ट पर बीट ये बॉटम टू टॉप ही बढ़ रही है. दिस इज अ पार्ट ऑफ मेमोरी हायरार्की. इफ यू कैन गो इन द डिटेल ऑफ दैट, फाउंड दैट द फास्टेस्ट एक्सेस टू द डेटा हैड इन द प्रोसेसर रजिस्टर. The register are at the top of the memory hierarchy. कभी भी जो register है ये memory hierarchy के top में है. Relatively, a small amount of memory that can be implemented on the processor chip and this processor cache, which can call it the primary cache. The two level of cache are to be found here. We are already given the detail of of that two caches, that is primary cache and secondary cache, where the primary cache will be coming in the level 1 of the processor chip, and secondary cache will be in the level 2, which is in between main memory and the processor. The next level is in the main memory, which is implemented as SIMS, that is much larger but much slower than the cache memory. Size में ज़्यादा रहती है but speed में कम रहती है. Next level is of magnetic disk, a huge amount of inexpensive storage. सबसे कम cost but उतना ही speed कम और size ज़्यादा. The speed of the memory access is critical, and the idea is to bring the instruction that and data that will be used in the near future as close to the processor as it possible. This is all about the simple basic idea of a memory hierarchy. Here a simple example of a memory hierarchy that here that we can show you, that memory hierarchy will be placed in terms of the 6 levels, starting from level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 4, level 5. So these are the different 6 levels will be given, and that 6 level given in the basis of their speed, on the basis of their cost, on the basis of their size of the operation. Now if you can discuss about a register L0, then in the level 0 there is a register that we already told you, that starting from the level 0 and then level 0 it comes as a register, and level 1 contains the on-chip L1 cache, that is primary cache, which is nothing but a static RAM. In between the register and a static RAM, we have found that the CPU register holds the word retry from L1 cache. If you can talk about the level 2, in that we found that a secondary cache, which you can call as off-chip L2 cache, static RAM. And if you can discuss about L1 and L2, we found that L1 cache hold the cache lines retrieved from the L2 cache memory. If you can discuss about L3, there is a main memory. That main memory is nothing but a dynamic RAM. And if you can discuss with L2 and L3, we found that L2 cache hold the cache lines which retrieved from the main memory. And if you can talk about L4, that in that case the local secondary storage, that is local disk, in between L2, L3 and L4, the main memory hold disk block retrieved from the local disk. If you can talk about L5, that is level 5, in that we found that the remote secondary storage, which is distributed file system as web servers also, and we can compare with L4 and L5, we found that the local disk hold the file retrieved from the disk on the remote network server. And if you can talk about the size, cost and speed, we found that they're from L5 to L0, it is a smaller, faster and costlier per bit storage device. And if you can talk about top to bottom, we found that it is a larger, slower and cheaper per bit to the storage device. So this is a simple example of memory hierarchy, where we can see the 6 total number of 6 levels from L0 to L5. L0 contains a register, L1 contains the primary cache, L2 contains a secondary cache, L3 contains the main memory, which will be called as the dynamic RAM, whereas the L4 contains the local secondary storage, the local disk, and L5 contains the remote secondary storage device. Okay. So this is all about the memory hierarchy and its structure. So thank you very much. This was a very important concept. You can go through details and clear your concept. Thank you.